Can I invite Carl?
Thank you, Chair, to introduce the report.
Thanks, Carl.
Thank you. Okay, so what I'm going to do for you is going to provide a walkthrough of the performance today. I'm going to focus on the year-end report. So, as an overview, on pages 25 to 30, we have the written summary report for quarter four. So this picks up out some of the key headlines from that particular quarter. And then, detailed between pages 31 to 40, we've got our standing item of the quarterly report, which provides more detailed overview in terms of the updated key outcome indicators and supporting measures for six pledge areas. So the quarterly report will compare the updated measures to the last reporting period. For example, that might be the previous quarter or the same quarter for the previous year. But as I mentioned, the main focus is going to be the update in terms of the year-end report, and I'll walk through that and explain how we put that together, because that will capture a summary of all the key events for the year. So if I refer you to pages 43 to 46. So first of all, just note that we've tried to take on some feedback from last year. I believe there were some comments from members about the report, the size of the report, and the level of detail. So what we've tried to do for you here is produce a more succinct report, and hopefully we've made that more user-friendly for you while still providing the appropriate level of detail. So hopefully that's evident within this, and we welcome any feedback or questions on that, both positive or negative. So, opening up first of all the environment summary. So that's on page 44. What we've done here, we've picked out some key achievements from each of these six pledge areas. So I'll just take an example here. So under community services, we've noted that £60,000 worth of funding was secured to help local community groups and organisations. So that was a key achievement within that area, and we've tried to balance that with also some of the potential areas for improvement, or where perhaps progress is ongoing or priorities have been readjusted. So you can see there, for example, looking at a track of local environment, you can see that performance was worsening. Currently detailed there, 31.6% of the 2020 target, 50%. What I would mention though is that since the report, because that's detailed quarter in arrears, the updated figure has improved to 33.2%, but we can acknowledge that there's still some work to go, and as we know, we have the Waste Management Plan of Action for 2018-19 to help make incremental improvements against that target. So, looking at page 45, we've got the two charts and then some narrative around each of the pledge areas. So this is to provide an overview in the first chart for the performance based on the previous year. So you can see we're looking at the trend and the outcome indicators based on 2016-17. So to provide some detail for you, there were 17 measures which were reported as NA. Pick that out because it seems like potentially a large number, but the reason for that is being that some of the data was not recorded initially at the start of the plan, or there'll be some data sets where we're still waiting for release, so that's where it's detailed as NA. A lot of them relate to the Healthier Lives pledge around the survey as well. But positive overall in terms of 16 measures were reported as better, and just 7 measures there as worse compared to last year. And worth noting that 2 of those measures actually relate to the FPNs for dog fouling and littering, and that was actually forecast for ourselves because this was profiled to be in line with behavioural change and raising awareness. So although their detail is worse, it's, you know, something that we were conscious of. The second pie chart there, that looks at the performance trend compared to the start of the plan. So again, on the same page, and you can see 15 measures were reported as NA. Again, as mentioned, that relates to the Healthier Lives pledge primarily. 16 measures were better, and just 8 measures were worse within the year. So overall, a positive picture. We've got the detail within each of the pledge areas on there for you. We turn over the page onto page 46. What we're doing here is we're trying to say, did we do what we said we would do? So in accordance with our action plan. So we've detailed the pie chart on the progress to date, and we can see a real high proportion of actions have either been completed or are still in progress for delivery by 2020. So that's a positive result for us. You may notice that our actions have been redefined. These are still in progress, however, the timescales have either been refreshed to reflect the expected completion date, or the wording has been made more specific to ensure clarity in delivery. The redefined actions are reflected within the new 18-19 action plans. There were just three actions withdrawn within the year, and in the accompanying appendix, pages 47 to 59, all the detail of the action plan progress is within there, and we include the rationale to explain that. So, hopefully, that provides you with kind of an overview of what the year-end report is trying to tell us. Overall, it seems to be quite a positive report for this portfolio area, and hopefully we provide that balance for you in terms of providing the level of detail, and also it's it's quite user-friendly. So we'd be happy to take any questions from you in relation to that. I've got Mark with me, he's got a lot of the detail there.
Okay, Christina.
Can I ask you a few questions from the 32-1
Yes.
First of all, on page 34, the commission episodes for alcohol and related conditions you've given us is worse. And then it says there is 12-month timeline on validated data being released. This data from the public health outreach framework relates to 2015-16. And what's the point of giving it to us then?
Chair, sometimes with data, we have to go on the best available at that time, so we'll use national data sets. We'll use survey data, or we'll have our own data internally. So in this instance, sometimes there's a time lag. Data has to be checked and verified before it's released. So I imagine this would be the case in this particular area. But obviously when looking at data, there may be time lags on that, but we have to use the best available to us.
So can I come back on that one, because there's a few I want to ask you about. All I can say is I'm sure on adult scrutiny we've seen more up-to-date information on admission episodes for alcohol-related conditions. And I would have thought that somewhere there's far more up-to-date information in 2015-16. I know I've read it, so if I've read it, anyone can read it. So, second of all is, I'm conscious that you wanted to finish at 7:30 for the next meeting, but I do want to ask some of them on the worst ones. Violence that causes an injury to an individual victim on page 38, which is worse, is that more concerned with domestic violence? Or is it concerned with all violence?
Sorry, which one was that, sir? 38, the last one. Is it whether that's national, sorry, or local? Is it
whether it's attributed to domestic violence?
I don't think it's specific to domestic violence. No, we have a separate pledge area for that.
Right. So we've got violent injuries that's increased. We've got the number of crimes recorded by the police is worse. Does that mean it's gone up or it's gone down? When it says reported, so you can imagine reporting is good.
Yeah, no, I know in the domestic violence. The indicator is such that more reports is recorded as better because we're trying to raise that awareness at a local level, but it's a highly complex area. And I know my team are doing some work on that with Mark Campbell at the moment as well to try and look at reporting. But I think in this instance, with it being a wider capture, it is, it's obviously it's worse because there are more cases, but I think it's more of a specific issue within the domestic abuse.
What I'm asking you is, if the number of recorded crimes has gone down, then how can violent injury have gone up? Because we know burglaries have gone up, and we know car crimes have gone up, because somewhere in here it fell. So I can question some of these figures, because they don't actually relate to each other.
For you, Chair, so I'm not sure whether I'm precisely answering Councillor Mushpat's question, but certainly in terms of one of the things we do know from the discussions we've had around the Safe for Rural Partnerships Board is that the police are reporting that, as we're showing that the number of crimes recorded in total numbers is certainly increased. One of the factors in that, I've been advised, is that there are certain kinds of crimes, such as cyber crime and internet crime, that are new and increasing forms of crime that are actually affecting some of those numbers. So just because the number is going up, it doesn't necessarily mean it's those traditional crime types.
Thank you for that, Mark, but I think most of us on our constituency committees have had it reported by the police there that crime is on the increase. So that might be a bit different than for you, I don't know. I just don't understand why it would be less if it's going. And then on page 33, the utilisation of outdoor space for exercise and health reasons. That's worse. Why is that?
We're losing subscribers because of the cost. Obviously, we need to mindful of that. The idea that officers can get a summary job, and this seems to be having a negative effect.
Through you, Chair, so I'm very mindful that we have got some new members around the table, so we have had some changes that way. Members will recall that since the start of the year, we've done work around the garden waste service, around what we can be doing to increase the numbers of subscribers. And some of you will remember that we actually had a budget option workshop earlier in the year. And now I think we had questions from Councillor Rennie and others about what that strategy is for actually increasing subscriber numbers. So I sent some information now from our commercial team, the booking team, at the time around that. And I'd be very happy to circulate that detail again to make sure all members of the committee have got that information. And that strategy that we're working through at the moment to increase those subscriber numbers and to make sure that performance measure is on track.
Adam. Thanks, Chair. Just a couple of questions. The first one was on a comment on page 44 about the review of the leisure services. What's the work council up to now? Because I think you've been working on this for about 3 or 4 years, haven't you? So, have you got any idea of the data point we are finally able to see something on that? And then on to the next page, on page 45, it does come round again. You did make comments on it about the contract that the measure is not very useful for the fixed penalty notices, because either we don't know whether either we're not doing enough fixed penalty notices because we're not catching people, or whether we're not. Or whether the behaviour is changing. So is there another measure we can use to find out whether the behaviour is changing? Is there something else? I know we've got the resident surveys on for a short period, but is there an interim measure we can put in? And then finally, I'm going to start using that work of redefining goals that aren't met by the end of the year. So there's nothing been not completed, everything's been redefined, so I'll let that go. So I'll start using that.
Okay, thank you, Chair. So just on the, just in terms of the leisure and culture review, I could take that away and possibly provide an update offline. I don't know whether Andrew's got anything to mention at this stage, or probably just come back to the committee at a later date. What do you think, Andrew?
That's very useful, Chair, if I may. My name's Andrew Elkington, and I'm the Interim Assistant Director of Community Services, which leisure forms part of my portfolio. To answer Councillor Sykes' question, not being in a particular specific way, it's pretty much. We're working with Cabinet members at the moment on proposals. They are slowly working their way through the council machinery. So as long as they jump all those hoops, I'm sure that narrative, that story, those proposals will be shared in a wider sense. I can't guarantee exactly when that will be, because obviously in various different groups there's a timetable that it does change. But yes, you're right, we need to have a long run up with this, but I think things are becoming clearer.
Ron, do you have a question?
Yeah, I'm going to read it. Just going back to the garden waste subscribers, it's difficult to understand. The pattern there for me is the numbers are going up. But if it's gone down, we need to have a start number, don't we? And we haven't got a start number, so it's difficult to understand whether it's up, down, or sideways, or backwards, or forwards. You've just got a number. All it says to me is our numbers are going up month, quarterly. It's a good thing. But what was our initial start number? Is it easy? You can't get a picture then. It's the moment. I've got the picture in my head, and we're off. Numbers are down. Let's just say we're down, but are we down by how many? Have we recovered the ground that we lost previously because we applied pounds online discounts of that ground we've recovered? It's difficult something to know. There's a new areas that people have joined that we haven't had before. Let's just start, which is a difficult situation against.
For you, Chair, just in terms of broad magnitude of numbers, I know that from memory we were working up to, we've been finishing about a year ago, just coming in under the 40,000 subscriber target. So I think that drop there, we probably just lost a couple of thousand to give you an idea of numbers.
So we're working,
we're working from a base. And that information I can certainly send out to members again was about, we've got, there was a budget option that went through the committee around actually increasing those subscriber numbers with a new marketing plan around that. And I'll send down further information on that target figure and those actions around that, absolutely.
On
the
basis,
sorry,
Chair, based on that, you just said, we started just on the 40,000. We're back to just on the 40,000. We've covered ground, so we are at a neutral position. So we're not worse off. We're not better off, but we're back to the position we're away from. So I just want to say, you know, the thing about it is the £5 reduction hasn't had the negative impact that we thought it would have. There's people who are joining the scheme, or new people are joining the scheme. I mean, that's the message we need to be getting out. Instead of dwelling on the negativity that things are always, they're not.
Yeah.
Actually, it's a good story there, because we coped with the ground we lost.
Okay.
Okay.
Hello. Thank you again for this report. It's good to see there's so many positive elements in this. But I would just like to pick out one of the negative ones on page 44, that reference to the waste recycling performance worsening down to 31.6% with a target of 50%. And I think that's particularly disappointing, because one would have hoped that, you know, we've got into the culture of recycling and that would become embedded. But clearly, a large number of residents are not cooperating with that. And I think we perhaps need to look again at an education scheme, perhaps putting more reminders out, a special item maybe in World View, if anybody reads it, or a special reading that's on the grain bins, what can go in, what can be recycled, and encourage people to boost that again. It is so important.
Through you, Chair, so as Carl outlined, so that 31.6 figure was that we're a quarter behind, so that was the quarter three figure. We've come in at end of year, you're right, so we've come in at 33.2%. So over the past few years, you know, we have seen a drop from the upper 30s. Interestingly, it's a city region trend and it's a national trend as well. So there's a whole series of factors there, but many authorities have had their waste systems and their schemes in place for quite a long time now, and all authorities across the country are facing that challenge of keeping those those behaviours running. One of the things that Mike touched on before was there was issues around some of those end markets for recyclers, and we called the 80s ban, the China crisis as well. So there's a whole variety of factors there that are making this challenging at a national level. What we have got for the coming year, so Chair, at the last meeting we talked briefly around some of the things we can do in our waste plan to work with the existing system that we've got to actually drive up those percentages. So we've got a new domestic waste policy, we're looking at doing bin take backs, we're looking at targeting the areas, we've got detailed intelligence of the streets that are participating in the grey bin recycling or not, as the case may be. So we're using that intelligence to target those locations, get people out on the ground, and get that educational awareness message over to them. So there's a whole raft of things that we're doing that are in the waste plan for the current year to certainly get that get that recycling figure back up into those early 30s, which is certainly where we need to be to be recovering that ground.
Okay, thanks, Mark. Any more questions to add? Steve?
During this political year, I've read leaflets from so-called responsible politicians making the direct connection between any new recycling initiative and a deterioration in their bin collection service. And that was put out by politicians around this room, and in my world, particularly from the Liberal Democrat group, who made that direct connection in people's minds, although it wasn't the end result. with the potential food waste recycling means you can actually be able to empty less. So when you put out negativity and you begin to see an effect on recycling means, then you reap what you sow. It wasn't a common sense debate around food waste, it was for the